Şimdi var mı engel olan?
Turkey's President Erdogan addresses an election rally in Diyarbakir, the southeastern city known to be the Kurdish heartland. He made it clear that no one should be seeking an independent state for Turkey's Kurds.
All citizens, including Kurds, are assured by the Turkish Republic. Other demands should be legitimate and within the rule of law.
Despite the Kurds' disappointment in the ruling party in the failed peace process, Erdogan still has strong support among some of them.
He values people. The previous leaders didn't treat us well, especially Kurds.
The ruling AK Party launched a peace process in the 2010s to find a way to end Turkey's decades-long conflict with the outlawed Kurdistan Workers' Party, or the PKK, a conflict that claimed more than 40,000 lives. But the fragile peace was short-lived. It effectively ended in 2015 when both sides resumed hostilities. The situation got more complicated when a state of emergency was declared following a failed coup in 2016.
At first, the government promised to lift the state of emergency in 3 months, but then it was used as a tool to design politics and opposition, and now it stands as the biggest obstacle against democratic channels.
People's Democratic Party, HDP, is the largest pro-Kurdish bloc and could be a game-changer if it wins more than 10% of the vote. This would likely rob the ruling party of its majority in parliament.
Over the last 3 years, he has taken a very hawkish, very militaristic, very aggressive, very masculine take on the Kurdish issue, and this is because he's trying to survive.
Kurds in southeastern Turkey have suffered most because of the government's security policies. President Erdogan is promising increased democracy and more embracing policies towards all citizens of Turkey. But the Kurds, who have supported Erdogan during the peace process, are curious how this will include them if the state of emergency is not lifted. The major question now is how to lure the vote of the Kurds again in this crucial legislative and presidential elections. Elections that will mark Turkey's transition to a new governance system headed by a very strong president. Sinem Koseoglu, Al Jazeera, Diyarbakir.